3, 2, 1, तेरे मेरे।
तेरे मेरे दरमिया है बातें अनकहीं, तू वहां है मैं यहाँ, क्यों साथ हम नहीं। फैसले जो किए फासले ली मेरे, राहें जुदा क्यों हो गए।
Thank you so much for joining Good Times, the Malik Brothers, as I will say. And many congratulations. It's what, 10 million views in 24 hours for Zara, you know, your song Zara Tero. Zara Tero, 10 million views. And also, Arman, congratulations. In the last 3 months, you've been the number one artist, English, Hindi, and Telugu, right?
Yes. Yeah, well done.
Wow, man. Well done. Honestly, so tell me about Zara Tero. So, were you anticipating so much love, and how did it come about?
I would like Amal to speak something about Zara Tero. Right now, there's another good news that we've hit number one on iTunes as well. So that's, I've just come in with that news for you.
Awesome.
So, I think Zara Tero is a very different song for me and for Arman. You know, we've collaborated on almost 20, 25 songs together, including films and non-film music. But this is something which is really different for me as a musician, because it's got a little Indian classical touch to it. And, you know, somewhere it's not what I've usually done for films or even for non-film music. So for me to come out with such a song, Arman to sing it, and, you know, for it in one day to win so many hearts, that's incredible. I wasn't expecting such a crazy response because it was something new we tried. But I'm really happy.
And what about you, Arman? Is the first song you've conceptualized, you've produced, you've shot, and so it's been actually a creatively satisfying lockdown for you.
It's actually been amazing. This lockdown has
had an in-house director.
Yeah, so Dad directed the video for me, and honestly, I wasn't very sure. Should we remove a single and should we come out with a proper music video in lockdown? But I think the end result just came out really, really nice. It doesn't seem like something I wouldn't be proud of a few years in the future. You know, when I look back at the video, I'll still be like, yeah, it really looks like a amazing music video. The whole process, actually, for Zara Tero, I had sung a scratch version of this song a few months back. But we weren't sure what to do with it. Amal wasn't sure whether it was a film song, whether it was a non-film song. And then obviously lockdown happened. So, uske baad to hum log ne socha hi nahi ki kya karna chahiye. But then Amal one day just called me and said, you know, this is a beautiful song. And I feel like, you know, it's the need of the hour. There's so much madness going on outside in the world. Ek aisa kuch gaana karte jisme sukoon hai. Thoda sa, there's a calm, there's a peace in the song. So I was like, you know, let's give it a shot. And this is the very studio that I'm sitting in. I recorded the song right here. And I sent the vocals to Amal, who then got Tulsi to dub her vocals from Delhi. Was she dubbing it from Delhi? So we've literally done a work on this song in different cities across India. And it's all come together in a beautiful way. So we definitely, we're the champions of the lockdown, you could say.
No, I totally agree with that. And two brothers composing together, what's it like when you are...
So, I must tell you, composer is him, I'm only the singer. He only composes. So unlike, like a lot of people, you know, confuse Amal and me as Amal Arman, like Vishal Shekhar or Salim Suleiman.
But we are completely
but
different.
We are not that at all.
We could never make a composer team because we have too many different ideas.
So even though we have collaborated on quite a few projects together, we have always maintained that, you know, I have my own lane of work and he has his own thing. So he's a purebred composer and I'm a singer. And like, we love collaborating with each other and with, you know, all the other people out there, all the other musicians.
I think I would say it's more like a blessing, you know, when we work together. Like, I've worked with many singers. I've worked with Arijit, Sonu Nigam, KK, and they've been all really fruitful, successful collaborations. But, you know, sometimes I feel whenever I come out with a song and Arman's leading the vocals on that, there is a sort of magic in it, which is like a forever stamp. You know, like our fans, they really look forward to it as if it's like a movie release of sorts. You know, it's not, it doesn't feel like it's a song releasing. So it feels like an entire festival on social media with such young kids responding to our music and, you know, treating it like, wow, we have something now, it's ours. You know, we have seen photos and tweets that kids have been putting. Wow, we have another Amal Arman collaboration for, you know, our playlist. So I think they look forward to this collaboration, and I feel every time we've come together, it's not just been successful, it's been forever, all those songs.
And both of you got success at such a young age that you have become like, you know, idols for a younger lot, but your journeys have been different. What would you want to say? What would you want to say about that? Because as Arman, you preferred going into singing competitions, and your name, despite that your grandfather also was a very well-respected artist, has never worked in your favor. So tell me about the fact that journeys have been different, two brothers sharing the same surname.
I think with both of us, we're very proud that we come from the Malik family. It's because of that that we have music in our blood, to be honest. And that we are able to create such amazing music, I think, is the blessing of our grandfather, Shri Sardar Malik. It's because of his blessing that we are able to create such kind of songs and put it out into the world. But from childhood, both Amal and I have always maintained that, you know, yes, we are Arman and Amal Malik, but we want to first make our names on our own steam and want to have our own journey. I started out by, you know, going on a reality show like Saregamapa, which no one from a filmy or a musical family would do that. No kid from a film or musical family would go out there and compete. I always wanted to do that because I wanted to prove to myself, hey, like if I feel like I'm a good singer, I want to put that to test and see whether I can compete against the top 10 not top 10, actually, there were 2,000, 3,000 people contesting for that. But I was fortunate enough to, you know, on my merit, come to top 10 in that show. So for me, it was my own personal journey and self-discovery ki, I am a Malik, but am I worth it? When I go and take a mic and I'm on that stage, are people listening to me because I sing well, or is it because I'm Arman Malik? So I submitted my name also as Arman from Mumbai. I never put my surname. I didn't want anyone to know that I'm from any family or whatever. I wanted them to hear my singing and judge me on that. So that's how I started. And Amal's journey kind of began in a very different way. He'll be better to explain to you how that journey began.
I think even what you've said is really beautiful. You know, like a very few people, you know, leave behind such a, you know, it's an illustrious career for my grandfather, my uncle, my dad. And, you know, it's easier to, you know, just maybe have that surname and have your dad like launch you in some music video or like something like that. But I don't think anyone from our family, you know, did that for us. Neither did we expect that. I think Arman also from a young age, even when he recorded for Vishal Shekhar.
Vishal Shekhar. Actually, I went and auditioned in his studio and you know, it's on that basis that I got the song. So, like for me, I went to different composers, gave my demo CDs, which Amal only helped me put together. Amal used to help me make these, you know, demo tracks. And that's how our journey began. You know, for us, it was reaching out to the musicians in our industry, not because of dad or anyone. We were just going out there and being like, hey, this is our music and this is what we do. Do you guys like it? He went to composers to assist them.
I think that was my toughest time. You know,
yeah,
like
it was crazy.
When I was about 16.
16.
That's the time when, you know, our grandfather also was quite ill. And, you know, my dad is very close to him. So he spent most of his time with, you know, my Dadaji. And somewhere we both were shouldering responsibilities of the family. And we both knew that it's up to us to now make our name on our own, you know. So I went out to assist in television shows, you know, work with composers like Raju Singh or maybe people who do background scores like Amar Mohile, Sandeep Chota, Salim Suleiman. You know, working with all these people, interacting with musicians like Pritam, you know, just being around and maybe seeing a recording was not that easy, you know, because somewhere a lot of other composers that I used to try and work and assist with, they used to feel that I'm a composer's son or a composer's nephew. So, you know, they would never hire me. So the struggle was even more difficult being, you know, this you know, the surname became more of a demon for me. I was like, everywhere I go, I don't get entry into the studio. So slowly and steadily, I think few composers who I've named, you know, felt that let's keep the surname aside and let's work with this boy on his talent and what he can achieve.
Amala told me this one thing. Chup Chup Ke went to Pritam's studio to listen to how a recording is done and see how is he doing
it. I've chased, like a young kid, I've chased all these composers' cars, gone to their studio, taken out a keyboard and played something and said, you know, just give me a chance and I'll show you what I can do. So after that, I've almost done about 28, 29 films as a music assistant, where, you know, background scores for maybe Race or Cocktail,
Pan Singh Tomar,
Rowdy Rathod, a lot of films with all of these composers. So that's what's been my learning curve. You know, I never got an overnight call and like, here you are and we both have come into Bollywood. A lot of youngsters also want to tell them that you're looking at the last 5 years being glorious. But if you go back, it's been 14 years
exactly.
of struggle for both of us.
Exactly. Yeah. So nobody realizes that. The hard work. They just see the fame that's come. And it's also not easy to sustain this fame also, because it's such a competitive industry. Every five years, somebody is, you know, replaced into somebody else. How do you cope up with it?
It's not even 5 years anymore. It's more like every 5 weeks now, because it's good in a way, you know, because I feel when I started trying for films and being a composer, it was more close than it is now. You know, musically, if you see, like now, if you say I have a surname, if you see a composer who doesn't belong from a musical family, maybe you take an Ankit Tiwari or an Orko, who are really good composers. They have come, made good music and cemented their own place. So, you know, musically, it's become a little more open since, you know, the last 5-7 years. Well, previously it was only, no, we'll work with this composer, or we'll work with only someone who's experienced, who's 35 plus, you know, because these were things which were maybe notions in producers' minds. You know, we need a person who's lived that life.
Even with singers, there used to be only Sonu Nigam, KK, Shan, Alka Yagnik, Shreya Ghoshal and Sunidhi Chauhan. These were the six singers in the industry at one point. And uske pehle it was Udit Kumar Shanu, sir. And then uske pehle there was Kishore Kumar, Mohammad Rafi, Lata Mangeshkar, Asha Bose. If you see, in all those eras, there have always been like five or six or max like seven people who used to do most of the work. But today, I think everyone has a shot at doing something, and all of us are coexisting in our own way. And it's now about who makes the best song.
Yeah.
You know, it's as simple as that. It's not about, you know, they've done this many body. I may have done 30, 35 songs. I may have won a Filmfare Award at the age of 21, but I still need to prove myself every day with
the
every
audience.
Song.
The audience is not, you know, someone who thinks about, it's past. Like, what have you done today? They are not going to judge us ki we've done 20 hit songs together, so the 21st must be great. So if Zarat Hero wasn't good enough, you know, we've got such loyal fans, you know, they will never even worry about telling us ki no, we didn't like the song. So, you know, that's the kind of fandom even we have. We've not got people who just continuously say good things. We've got young kids who also come up to me and say, we wish this music section was longer. So we've got really thinking fans, you know, so I really like that. And maybe you can say today the careers are a little difficult to, you know, maintain compared to the past. You know,
it's short-lived. But that also must be creating anxiety and stress also.
It definitely does. I think me and Amal, the kind of careers we have had till in the last, you know, 5 to 6 years, I think that 5 to 6 years has amounted to 10 to 12 years or 15 years of work of other people in other eras. The way the industry has grown in those 5-6 years has been crazy. To seeing solo albums go into multi-composer albums, multi-composer albums going into then people doing recreations, and then now recreations now are not being accepted by the public, to people doing singles now. So there's been crazy waves through all the whole last 5-6 years that Amal and me have actively been there in the music industry. And the only thing, I think the thing that keeps us going is making good music at the end of the day. We have to, yesterday TikTok got banned, today Instagram ka something new has come. We have to accept that and go with that. There are always new things always coming up, and we have to see how how we attach to it and how we use it to our advantage.
I'm already pissed off with the new Instagram.
I know the reels, no?
It's too much.
I mean, it's see, they are catering to an audience where they feel like, okay, ye nahi tha to ye hai.
Sahi mein.
Right. Yeah, but like it's I'm saying it from a perspective how things are changing. The landscape of the industry is changing in like months. Like, and we just need to, as musicians, make music for sure. 80%, I feel 80% focus has to be on music. A lot of people focus on the other stuff more and less on the music. But sab kuch hone ke baad bhi agar gaana acha nahi hai, so then it fails. You know,
because today we've got so many, you know, streaming platforms. We've got YouTube's grown bigger than, you know, just 5 years back. I remember my film CD used to come out. And that's no more. There's no such thing.
5 years back. Long back.
No, 2014-15 CDs were still on. Like when I did MS Dhoni's album, there was a CD
launch. Uske baad CD launch hua tha, mar aapko CD launch nahi hota.
Now
you will see this on some streaming platform.
So you know, a lot of it's become, you know, musically also the audience, in spite of, you know, one side being completely digitalized and getting numbers and streams and all that, it has to still be a good song. You know, there are times where people promote their song and maybe get incredible numbers. But there are the common man or someone on the road who I meet or someone who's working in my building. I always keep a ear out ki what are these guys listening to? What is their music? Because I know what is his music, what's my music or our friends. But that's India. That's the audience that I look out for. So I get to know, that's my immediate answer. Okay, this is what...
Which is so true. What you've said, Javed Akhtar once told me, suno jo cycle chala raha hai, wo kaun si dhun ga raha hai. Basically, everyone's a singer. They'll be humming a tune. He says, that's where you get your thing. Which is so true. But what's the one change you want to see in the music industry, if there is any? A change that you would...
I think just more streamlining in the industry is required in terms of like royalties, in terms of publishing, in terms of equal rights for creators. You know, with all due respect to all the labels and the music companies, they've been used to a certain way of working in the Indian music industry, which is very different from the West. Now, since in 2020, I have started singing English songs.
And you've been signed on also. Congratulations.
Yes, I've signed a label deal with a US label. So I know how that side of things work. Even though there are labels there, you know, they have a certain way of working where it's the kind of income that an artist sees from a song in terms of royalties, in terms of, you know, getting a percentage of what the song is making. Those are small little things that I feel go a long way, because a few days back, I think Dad was sharing a story about some lyric writer who passed away, and he didn't have enough money in his account in his, you know, in these days where he's not in his prime. But that's not the case with a lot of writers and producers in the West, because they may have created one or two hit songs and 20 normal songs which didn't do that well. But their whole, they have 2-3 generations who live off of the money that song generates and makes. So I feel it's starting in a way. You know, IPRS as a company headed by Javed Akhtar sir has started to see that a change is being made for creators to get, you know, proper royalties. It's still not at the level of what West is operating at. But slowly, I think in the coming few years with the resurgence of the 90s wala door of non-film music, which we want it to come badly. So that's already happening. So with that happening, I think all these laws and rules will be better, and creators will be... Creators, when I mean by creators, I mean by all composers, lyric writers, and if singers have co-created or co-composed, sometimes there are, you know, sessions that happen between people. So the way I see that, people collaborate there a lot, and every person who's involved in the song gets a share of whatever they have done. You know, so it's a beautiful
thing. It makes it a happier environment to, you know, work. What I feel is that when you work now for a movie, you assign all your rights to that film or to that label that's, you know, part of that film, that's producing the music for that film.
Yeah.
Tomorrow, the label, through streaming, through views, through caller tunes, through placements in ads, there's several mediums for them to earn money. But they give you a figure which maybe won't last you the next 2 months also. So I think somewhere they have to be fair, you know, it has to be a general rule. Yeah. You know, where you can...
But they've been so used to working in this way.
That's for because, so many that's years. Also because also what I feel that because there hasn't been unity for quite a few years. You know, a lot of composers and singers, everyone is like, let's make our money, let's get done with our time.
Yeah, I think they don't stand together.
No, it's not only about that. It's more about like, listen, we don't want to worry about what may come. We're getting this money in hand, like the one-time fee that we're getting. This is more important because this is going to help us bring food on the table now. Like, hume future ka bhi pata nahi hai ki kya, what will happen or what royalties will come in. And
so all of that's them the scare. And all of them have also spoken, like, now everyone's getting to know about this because the world's opening up so much. People are, like, if Arman's working internationally, there are so many international musicians that, you know, maybe I want to collaborate with or use them on my songs. They refuse to work on an Indian project because they say your royalty system isn't in place. So, you know, that's such a big hindrance for a creator like me or any musician who wants to get an artist down to just play a part in my song. The system of royalties and, you know, sharing those rights with people who create. You know, it's not the label who creates. It's not a film director. It's not an actor who creates the music. It's the composer. It's the lyric writer. It's the singer. It's the music producer. So obviously, it's and then obviously these are the people who select our music
and amplify it by marketing it.
So somewhere, you know, they have to come to a midpoint where all these authors who are the creators are happy. You know, otherwise I'm seeing so many younger, you know, people also not wanting to be the composers and lyricists. They want to be singers. Fly by night. They just want to be a singer.
Yeah.
Okay, okay, we'll sing one hit song. We'll do 10 shows and we'll make money. So they're actually killing two very important art forms of our country, of writing and composing. So I think the more people know, you know, educate themselves,
get knowledge about this, yeah.
Just so agree with that. And since both of you collaborate, who is the easier one to deal with and who is the tougher one?
So I'm pretty easy to deal with. he's very, very tough to deal with.
Say why?
No. I'll tell why. There are pros and cons. The pros are that I get to be a better singer every time I sing with him. So he doesn't let me go so easily. Like I can't just do a okay take and be like, ha, Amal's accepted it. No, he will make me bleed till I get the line right or the what he wants, what he's envisioning for the song. So that way, I think through the process, I become a better singer in the studio. The con is that I get frustrated and I leave the studio and tell him I'm not recording for you anymore. I'm done.
That wo bhai bhai ka to chalega hi.
Haan, nahi, haan, to ye bhai bhai mein bahut, matlab, liberty leta hai. Iske
saath thoda zyada ho jata hai, kyunki...
But off late, actually, I've not got a lot of complaints from him because I think I've learned how to sing for him. Now I know what I need to deliver for him to be happy. So I think Zara Thehro aur uske do teen chale jo gaane the, usme mujhko itni daant nahi padi.
तुम दोनों का अपना पर्सनल कौन सा है कंपोजिशन फेवरेट दैट यू हैव डन लाइक यू हैव सैंग एंड यू हैव कंपोज योर वन पर्सनल फेवरेट आई नो सारे इक्वल होते हैं
लेट्स डू वन थिंग वील से 3-2-1 एंड वील से द सॉन्ग दैट वी फील इज द मोस्ट फेवरेट
ओके
वील से इट एंड देन वील सिंग इट
ठीक है ठीक
है चलो सो 3-2-1
तेरे मेरे दरमियां है बातें अनकही तू वहाँ है मैं यहाँ क्यों साथ हम नहीं फैसले जो किए फासले मिले राहें जुदा क्यों हो गए ना तू गलत ना मैं सही ले जा मुझे साथ तेरे मुझको ना रहना साथ मेरे ले जा मुझे साथ तेरे मुझको ना रहना साथ मेरे ले जा मुझे ले जा मुझे
Awesome! My God, you guys really deserve the success you do. Thank you so much. Will we ever see both of you coming together? Like, you know, we've seen teams together, the Malik brothers doing something together, like films, like a duo. Or will you want to do your own separate thing?
I think in the future, actually, there are a lot of surprises coming from Amal's end. This year, he is also going to do something very different. People will see him also in a different space and, you know, in a different avatar. So once he starts on that journey, I think both of us should collaborate on a single where we both are featured in the video. I think that would be really cool.
I think I'm just taking my initial steps as, you know, featuring in a music video, and it's going to happen really soon. So once I've done a few singles and I'm ready to face Arman in a video, maybe it'll be a battle of sorts. We'll do some cool
looking song. Forward to that. And you've also signed English, so many languages. Ab yeah. kuch waise bacha hai aur kuch bacha hai
waise? Bacha to matlab bahut hai abhi. Matlab maine South Indian to kafi ga li hai. Hindi bhi ga chuka hun aur English is saal maine I did my debut. Abhi haan वैसे तो इंडियन लैंग्वेजेस आई हैव sung a lot of songs in like Gujarati, Bengali, Marathi. But like, I want to try my hand at Arabic and Spanish also next now. So awesome. Let's hope.
You're going to be awesome. 2 years ago, he said, I have a lot more bubbly music left in me. Abhi wo kuch wo bubbly music aaya bhagi, abhi aur dekhenge hum.
So, English mein jo maine gana nikala hai, dono. Actually, the first one is more up-tempo and more energetic, Control. That was the name of the first single. So if you listen to that, that's very unlike my kind of songs that I've been doing in Bollywood and in the Indian space. So I think I'm breaking genres and like kind of doing different stuff. So bahut dekhne ko milega.
Thank you so much and all the very best. Keep the good times going since you're speaking to good times. Thank you very much, both of you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye. Lovely talking to you. Bye-bye. Bye.
Same here. Thank you.
Bye.